that it is true. When we said to him that Satan sleep in his nose, according to his prophet, he said it's true. Because when he clean his nose, he feel more comfortable. So he helped us in a very scientific way to prove something was confusing us. This is number one. Number two, when we ask him about the hadith that Satan take care of from his butt, he said in a very honest way, he cannot answer me about that because his ass is bald. And because his ass is bald, he cannot really tell us what exactly happened if Satan take care, because how he can take care if he don't have any, which makes sense. When we said to him that Satan he do pee in his ears, he did not answer this one. And this is why I want to get back to you, Abu Hanafi, to tell me how Satan he can pee in the ears of Muslim when Satan don't have a physical body, as you said, your mind.
Okay, I just want to answer that person, Al-Ghalban, okay? Well, first of all, I think Muhammad, not everything Muhammad did, we are allowed to do the same thing, okay? For example, Muhammad married more than 7 wives, okay? And in Islam, a man is allowed to marry up to 4 wives, okay? So Muhammad has a lot of, you may call it them privileges and exceptions, but not all Muslims have it, okay? Okay, so this is the case, and I think Muhammad actually did marry Aisha at that age, because Muhammad Muhammad wanted a person who is able to memorize everything happening between him and her, and therefore she can tell people around what was going on, and people would understand Islam perfect and everything and on all details. Okay, that's all I can tell you. Okay. Anyway, I think I'm gonna stay in just 2 minutes. I'm gonna take the sack. Okay. Good night for now. Bye.
Oh, Wayne, where are you going, Hanafi? Where are you going? Come on, guys. Anyone would like to convert to Islam after we heard all those things from Abu Hanafi? Anyone want to take Shahada before he leave? The new crusader, you want to take Shahada? Okay, let me get my scissor first to cut your the piece down there, because they have to cut you there down. Islam is a religion. They cut your piece down when you join. They cut their head when you leave. Okay, they chop you down, chop your head. To Abu Hanafi, listen. When we listen to you honestly, we see that you are really presenting Muslims in a very good way. And I don't want you to leave. Do you like to be an admin in our room? Abu Hanafi, do you like me to make you an admin, your mind?
Okay, thanks. Thanks for... but I think Jada 58 hates me, okay? So I don't think she would accept me as an admin, okay?
No, it's my decision, not her decision. This is my room, sir. Trust me, if you say yes, I'm serious. I'm serious. I am the one who make decision here, not Jada, with my respect to her. If you want to be an admin, I will make an admin right now, and you can come back with your hat. What do you think? You're Mike. And you debate all the Christians in here. What do you mean no? Okay, I will pay you. Deal? No, Mike.
Okay, so why you want me actually to be an admin here? I don't stay in bathtub for a long time, just, you know, moving from one room to a room, and, you know, that's all I do. Maybe some making some clown show circus. anyway, mic is yours.
Look, let me tell you what will happen if you became an admin in our room. First, Muslims, they would love your answers. And you will make Muslims proud about their religion. This is number one. Number two, you will bring victory for Islam. Number three, you will make a Christian look really like dummies. Because this is what you did for the last 2 hours. Like, I'm really shocked. So I'm giving you an offer which you should not deny, because this will support Islam. And honestly, I do not know why you are rejecting such an offer. Are you scared? Abu Hanafi, are you scared that Muslims, they will be against you if you became an admin in this room? They will do something to you? Are you a coward or something? Come on, tell me your mind.
Well, I said thank you, and thank you is enough, okay? But I don't have heaps of time to, you know, stay in Balto, okay? And I think room has 100, okay? Room reaches 100 user right now. This is a real, really big number, okay? I don't think it's a good idea to have a Muslim guy, wow, with his explosive, you know, belt around his belly. Okay, you know, you may have that person, saint is a good person, you know, you may have him an admin, and you know, it's really some kind of paradox, you have a Muslim admin in a Christian room, okay, it's not a normal Christian, it's a Christian prince room, okay. Mic is yours.
Well, you know, Jada, listen. First, in here, in our room, if somebody have a name, but the name is not showing a clear message, we don't bounce him because of his name. If he do something, then we do deal with him. There's no need to bounce people just because his name, it might mean something. There's people, they enter the room, they, you know, their name is cursing me or even calling me names. We will not bounce them. If he do something bad, then we will deal with him. Not because we don't like the name, we bounce him. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You know, when we open a chat room, we don't, you know, we are not the one who will control the word, and we will make people say and change their mind by bouncing them. You want to change the mind of people, let them stay. If you want to show them that they are wrong, and maybe he will never do that again, it's not by bouncing the person, it's by let him stay and learn that he's wrong. Abu, listen, I don't know what IST she want to say to you, but I think you are great, and you can be a great admin. This is why I wanted you to be an admin in here. And actually, I'm thinking about making like an announcement in a newspaper to hire like 4, 5, 6 Muslims in my room as admins, and I will change all the Christian admins in here, man. They are boring for me. Honestly, the Muslim admins, they are the best. It's fun, man. Because by having Muslim admins with me, I will debate the admins. I do not need to look for Muslims to debate me. And by this, hallelujah,